5. The Book of Greetings. Chapter 131. Excellence of Promoting Greetings. Allah the Exalted says, O you who believe, enter not houses other than your own until you have asked permission and greeted those in them. 24:27. But when you enter the houses, greet one another with a greeting from Allah, i.e., say, As-Salamu Alaikum, peace be upon you, blessed and good. 24:61. When you are greeted with a greeting, greet in return with what is better than it, or at least return it equally. 4:86. Has the story reached you of the honored guests, three angels, Jibril, Gabriel, along with another two, of Ibrahim, Abraham, peace be upon him, when they came into him and said, Salam, peace be upon you. He answered, Salam, peace be upon you. 51:24-25. 8:45. Abdullah bin Amr bin al-As radiyallahu anhuma reported, a man asked the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, which act in Islam is the best? He, peace be upon him, replied, to give food and to greet everyone, whether you know or you do not. Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Commentary. Feeding poor and destitute is an act of goodness, and so is fulfilling the needs of the indigent. Greeting everybody saying As-Salaamu Alaikum, whether an acquaintance or a stranger, is a good manner too. Both of these acts generate mutual love and remove hatred and ill will from hearts. All other forms of greetings do not substitute for the Islamic greeting. 8:46. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu reported, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, when Allah created Adam, peace be upon him, he said to him, go and greet that company of angels who are sitting there, and then listen to what they are going to say in reply to your greetings, because that will be your greeting and your offspring's. Adam, peace be upon him, said to the angels, As-salamu alaykum, may you be safe from evil. They replied, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, may you be safe from evil and mercy of Allah be upon you. Thus adding in reply to him, wa rahmatullah and mercy of Allah to his greeting. Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Commentary. The Islamic form of greeting, As-salamu alaykum, may you be safe from evil, has been in existence since the days of the Prophet Adam, peace be upon him. According to some ahadith, it is better to add in response, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, and the mercy and blessings of Allah. 8:47. Al-Bara bin Azib radiyallahu anhuma reported, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, commanded us to do seven things: to visit the sick, to follow the funeral of a dead believer, to invoke the mercy of Allah upon one who sneezes, i.e. by saying to him, Yarhamkumullah, to support the weak, to help the oppressed, to promote the greeting of As-salamu alaykum, and to help those who swear to do something to keep their oaths. Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Commentary. Muslims have obligations towards one another. The fulfillment of this social responsibility creates among them mutual love, a sense of cohesion, and feelings of respect for one another. 8:48. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu reported, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, by him in whose hand is my life, you will not enter Jannah until you believe, and you will not believe until you love one another. Shall I inform you of something which, if you do, you will love one another? Promote greetings amongst yourselves. Muslim. Commentary. Iman is a prerequisite for entry to Jannah, whereas mutual love among Muslims is complementary to it. And this quality can only be attained by giving a social character to the Islamic form of greeting, that is to say, As-salamu alaykum. 8:49. Abdullah bin Salam radiyallahu anhu reported, I heard the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, saying, O people, exchange greetings of peace, i.e. say, As-salamu alaykum to one another, feed people, strengthen the ties of kinship, and be in prayer when others are asleep. You will enter Jannah in peace. At-Tirmidhi. Commentary. All these habits and practices are indispensable to a believer because each one of them leads to Jannah, with the first people to enter it without being punished in hell first. 8:50. At-Tufail bin Ubay bin Qab, radiyallahu anhu, reported, I used to visit Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhuma in the morning and accompany him to the market. Abdullah offered greetings of peace to everyone he met on the way, be they sellers of petty goods, traders, or poor people. One day, when I came to him, he asked me to accompany him to the market. I said to him, "What is the point of your going to the market when you do not sell, nor ask about articles, nor offer a price for them, nor sit down with any company of people? Let us sit down here and talk." He replied, "O Abu Batn, belly, Tufail had a large belly. We go to the market to greet everyone we meet." Malik. Commentary. This hadith highlights Abdullah bin Umar's passion for promoting salam, which is a practice of sunnah. Secondly, we can call a person by his epithetic name provided he is not offended by it.